Recording.
Okay, what we're going to do today is answer the questions about the walking. I showed that there's two basic walks that are important and essential in Wing Chun to learning how to move. And one was the 1-2-3 walk, and the other one was 1-2 turn out, step through, 1-2 turn out, step through. So you don't want to be walking like that in actual application. When you reach third form, they say your Sifu level, and you can walk with your feet pointing out, and you can do your forms with your feet pointing out. Although typically if you're demonstrating Silomdao, you would still have your toes in for the form. But we built our foundation, this tripod and all the dynamics of it that I've explained in another video. So here it is. We come into application and you're going to move into contacting an opponent. One of the things that we are wanting to be very careful about is, I've mentioned in a different video, is we don't have this hanging toe stance with 1 foot forward, 1 foot behind it. We would call that haomao in the Wing Chun. We do have haomao. It's not that you can't have 1 foot in front of the other, but we don't have this hanging toe stance with the hips turned off and the shoulders turned off. That's pretty typical. So what we do is we advance toward another person, and the gurkjons help us with distancing as well as playing chi gurk together. We do the chi gurk in a fixed position, but then we do it where we meet, one kick meets the other person's kick. Come over here for a minute, Scott. Come in and kick. And I meet, look at that, that was sensational. But he just got back from Hawaii, so it's the pai pai juice or something. So we do raging kicks, and we do connect. And then you can see with the chi gurk, I'm actually pulling his leg, ending up where I want to end up. I can break that if I wanted to. So what we've done there, you step out. What we've done is we do make those connections when we're there. We have to be close enough for that to happen. And as that happens, we're just kind of pretty much fairly normal here, and our weight is always ready. We can always block. We can always do a different kind of block. We can always do a kick and then step in, but the hips don't turn off. So if I go up to block, instead of the hanging toe stance that you might be familiar with from some kung fu and karates, instead of a hanging toe stance and being turned off this way and then kicking like that and then maybe turning and doing a back spin, what I want to do is have my hips facing forward so that either leg can be used. Not this leg and then maybe later that leg. I want either one. Whichever one I shift my weight, I can use either leg to block or to kick. And as I get closer, come up to you, I may block. I might block my groin. I come down in what essentially looks like a hanging toe stance, but here, the waist is facing forward, the shoulders are facing forward. So that's the big difference there, is that you're facing this way. It feels awkward when you begin to face your opponent straight on like this. You feel very open and vulnerable, but you're really not, because you can always block. And you allow yourself the ability, you block here or whatever, you still have in that, what would be the equivalent of a hanging toe stance, hips are facing on, and now you can use either leg as needed. And especially, you can also still launch your punches, and both punches are here and ready to go. Both strikes, both essentially what people think of as grappling, with the chi sao moves, the lop saos, and all the different things that you do in combat, are both available at all times to be used. So we don't change the shoulders. So what's the deal with all this walking stuff? Well, it's to teach you strength. It's to teach you to use the hip in order to deliver a lot of power out of your punching and movements and all that kind of stuff to make your juts really strong as you connect everything together. But when it comes down to practical application, you're not walking in like this. Although I think that would be entertaining, especially if you kick somebody's ass, which we don't want to do. So keep the hips facing on. Understand that you can still do all of your responses. You can use either leg. Your arms are ready to go, and you're gonna walk in like a normal person. You may be in a haomao type stance, and your toes will not be pointing in like this. This is the stuff we get into when we talk about the physics of the Wing Chun. It's technical. It's not rocket science, but it's technical. You have to get into the details. When you put them all together, you end up with an exceptional kung fu. That's it.